improbable piety, courage, achieves an impossible result. And attain an imperishable crown. Anything unattempted. Let me say this. Anything unattempted remains impossible. Don't be afraid to take the next step. For it is said in the book of Philippians 4:13, I can do anything through Christ who strengthens me.
Yes.
Thank you and God bless you.
Yeah, thank you, Mr. Omaga, for that motivational speech to younger generations. Because we are running short of time, we are going to speed up the process later. But right now, since our real father has already spoken to us, he wants to be, and he has to be excused to go back to his room. All right, so we.
Hallelujah, Kaje. Hallelujah, Kaje.
Hallelujah.
All right. We're back up. And all the members of the executive please come out and then and the board of trustees. Members of the executives and members of the board of trustees, please come out.
Okay. We ready?
Quickly, Houston chapter, get ready. Houston chapter.
All right.
Okay.
Then after that, I think there's going to be
group
program. Everybody. Is any member of the Houston Center still around? Please come in. Houston is going.
Sir?
Children, get ready.
Hold on.
Vaccine.
see your doctors, we should need you at least yearly do routine screening for you. A screening is to identify a disease before you have the symptoms. So that a disease that can be treated, it can be diagnosed early enough, like cancer, and then the treatment given. The recommendation from the CDC is that if between the age of 18 and 21, when you see your doctor every year, they should examine you, make sure that your medication is up to date. Then between the age of 22 and 29, if you don't have any problem at all, make sure you have a checkup at least once every 1 to 3 years. Then between the age of 30 and 39, until you get to your 50, if you don't have any problem, make sure to see a doctor at least once every 1 to 3 years to have all your medication updated and your physical done. And after the age of 50, you should see a doctor every year with or without problem. There are some common conditions that you can screen for. We are looking at those ones that screening can really make a difference. If you are ladies, you're looking at breast cancer, cervical cancer. Then we have colorectal cancer, then prostate cancer in men. The other diseases like glaucoma, diabetes, high blood pressure. So we just quickly go through the recommendation for screening for this. To start with breast cancer. Breast cancer affects 1 in 8 women during their lives. Breast cancer kills more women in the United States today than any other cancer except lung cancer. Symptoms of breast cancer may include a lump in the breast or a change in size of or shape of the breast. Men can also have breast cancer, but the number is too small and they don't really focus on. The risk factors of breast cancer, as you grow older, you have your risk of breast cancer increases. Then there are genes that are identified that make you prone to having breast cancer. This was the gene that was found in Angelina Jolie that she decided to remove both breasts. It's actually as serious as that. Then the personal factors, those that started having their period before the age of 12 or going through menopause after age of 55, you will find that your risk of breast cancer increases. So those type of people should get checked regularly. Then the other risk factors, some of them that we can control, like being overweight, or using a hormone replacement therapy like birth control, drinking alcohol. Then people that may have any children or have children at the age of 35 or have them grow, they are increased risk of having breast cancer. So when you fall through these categories or based on your age, your physician should emphasize the following. One, you should teach you how to do clinical breast exam. You should be able to do your self-breast examination. It's always advised that as a lady, when you are in the shower, examine your breast. Look at the breast in the mirror. If there's a difference in the size or in the shape of your breast, then you should see your doctor and there's something wrong. Then your doctor can do mammogram or can recommend the MRI for diagnosis. So the guidelines for screening for breast cancer, between the age of 18 and 39, so that is 20 or a little bit earlier, you should have breast exam done at all health visits. Then those that have risk factors that are already listed, they should have the mammogram done. Then between the, after the age of 40, you should have breast exam done at the early interval. Then between the age of 40 and 49, your doctor should discuss with you the risk of having a mammogram done every 2 years. Then from after the age of 50, you should really have mammogram done every 2 years. And that should continue until the age of 74. Then your doctor can decide after that if there's this point. Then the other thing we can look at is cervical cancer. Cervical cancer awareness month in January. So what we're trying to advise is that a lot of these cancers are screening, they have different months that are assigned to them. If you keep the log of the month, when you know that January is cervical cancer awareness month,
you cannot get out of it, but you can do something about it. And when you know what it is, you work towards it. I had a brochure that I made, it's in form of PowerPoint. The copies are not here. When the copies are available, we can put it on the net as well. That way, there are parameters, like Normal blood pressure is, you know, should be below 120 over 80. Anything above that, you are in like stage one. If your blood pressure is 160 over 100, that is stage two, high blood pressure. So, and the risk factor, there are modifiable ones and there are non-modifiable ones. The non-modifiable ones is your race. You can't change your race. Your ethnicity, you can't change that. But you can change smoking. Those are modifiable ones. Smoking is modifiable. Obesity is the biggie. Is modifiable. Obesity is being defined as the disease of excess in America. Obesity can be reduced by portion sizes, regular exercise. It doesn't have to be long, 10 to 15 minutes. Every day, let it be consistent. And then you will help yourself. Eating, our eating habits is a biggie. Frying of food is not good. As you fry any food, you make the fat to be trans fat. Trans fat behaves like animal fat that clog up your arteries. That is how we have heart attack. And any artery that is clogged, there will not be blood flow. Blood contains all the oxygen and the nutrients to that particular tissue. There will not be a flow of blood to that particular tissue, and the tissue will die. If it affects your brain, you have a stroke. If it affects your heart, you have heart attack. They are all preventable. Those are modifiable factors of high blood pressure. Alcohol is another one. It's modifiable. So we will be setting up our table up there. If you have more questions, we can answer your question. Because it's like we are in a hurry to go and eat. And food is here, we can make food choices. So bless you all. Our blood pressure measurement is the better one is be taken on arising up in the morning. When you wake up in the morning.
We serve our people from Nigeria. First, then from there, we can.
Happy birthday to you.
Hold on. There's no Igala version for that song. Matthew, is there no Igala version for that song?
Gold medal, mommy, for some other. Bellows.
Thank you so much.
Can we give another round of applause? applause. Our Excellency and His Excellency. Thank you very much. On behalf of the association, please extend our sincere appreciation to His Excellency and Her Excellency for their generous donations to the organization. Thank them for all the support over the years. I want to thank them especially for this one. All right. We are going to move forward. So there are two major presentations again. One probably on the legal side and of course on the educational side. Just okay, alright, so Mrs. Adi Arigia Amadi also is going to be talking on health and entrepreneurship. Because of the time constraints, we're probably going to cut down on the length of the presentation. I know these are
about me. This presentation is about. I'm also glad about the things I heard here all through the day. We talked about health and we talked about entrepreneurship. One is about a multi-billion-dollar company. This company is run by three gentlemen, noblemen of the world: Bernard Desoix, Sean Moran, and Bolton Hall. Bolton Balls. These three people, led by Bernard Desoix, have been able to infuse what you call Ganoderma lacidium into the finest beans of coffee around the world. So the business is about coffee, tea, however you take it. Can you roll the slides for me, please? It's a fast-growing business. As soon as you hook onto this business, you'll be on the internet. You'll have your space in the Organigold website. It's home-based business. You don't have to have a shop. You don't have to have minders to run this business. It's health and wellness industry. The Ganoderma lacidium, which has been infused into coffee, is a mushroom with a history of over 2,000 years. The Chinese royals have kept it as theirs, but now it is open to the world. This business aims to bring the treasures of the earth to the people of the world. Next slide, please. Treasures, bringing the treasures of the world, of the earth, to the people of the world. Next slide. We all know that right now in the world, about 1.6 billion cups of coffee are made around the world every day. So coffee right now is the fastest growing business. But this coffee is not the coffee you are used to. We are not talking about caffeine here. The infusion of Ganoderma lacidium into this coffee has removed all the caffeine. What you have there is just treats. The normal coffee has 36 milligrams of coffee. The caffeinated has about 20 something, but this has 9 milligrams, which is just like a trace of it. And the Ganoderma lacidium is supposed to bring you health. It has been known to help people with lowering cholesterol, blood pressure, help with arthritis, and of course, for the ladies in house and gentlemen and women, it is also anti-aging. You remain young and healthy for much longer. Next slide, please. Next slide. That's the mushroom, the Ganoderma lacidium. Let's move on. As soon as this business was founded, the Chinese government gave the Organigold company money to build these infrastructures. Money free, not grants or loan that had to be paid back. Let's move on. Can you roll the slides quickly? And these are the products involved. I'm going to enable us to sample these products. I brought samples which I'll give to everyone today. Let's move on. These are the gentlemen of the business. Let's move on. This company has a standing relationship with the Napoleon Hill Foundation, talking about entrepreneurship, talking about focusing, talking about staying on it for as long as possible. Next slide. Next slide. Next slide. At this juncture, I have a business partner in-house, and I want him to quickly talk about the financial implication of joining the business and running with the business, and how you can turn it into the multi-billion dollar business that it is. I have Richard Gabriel and Kenny, his lovely wife here. They are both from Trinidad and Tobago. He is an emerald consultant with the Organo Gold Company. This is to say that his business manages something in the region of between $80,000 to $200,000 monthly. He came into this business from the energy sector. I just came in from Los Angeles, where we attended the convention. We have stories of men and women, couples, who have left regular business to be in the organogold business. There was this guy who told his story here. A family of about 14, mother and father inclusive, they lived in the same house in Thailand, in the same room in Thailand. Over a while, they could not pay their bill. But one of them chanced on the organogold multi-million dollar business. And today, he is a success story. They have a house, they ride a car, they move around and live the number one lifestyle. Some other person also told the story of how he has asked two of his children to step out of school for 1 year to run the organogold business.